From the personal log of Guybrush Threepwood. Sometimes, when it's quiet, I can still hear the monkeys. It's hard to believe that it's only been a few years since I first washed up on the beaches of Melee Island, armed with nothing more than a goofy name and an overpowering urge to become a swashbuckling pirate. I want... From the personal log of Guybrush Threepwood. Sometimes, when it's quiet, I can still hear the monkeys. It's hard to believe that it's only been a few years since I first washed up on the beaches of Melee Island, armed with nothing more than a goofy name and an overpowering urge to become a swashbuckling pirate. I want to be a pirate. Who could have suspected that such a humble pursuit would lead me to cross swords with the evil ghost pirate LeChuck, the slimiest slug ever to plunder the seven seas? And who could have guessed that my battles with LeChuck would introduce me to the love of my life, Melee Island's Governor Elaine Marley. Or that my efforts to win Elaine's hand would repeatedly drag me to the mystery-drenched shores of Monkey Island. That's the second biggest monkey head I've ever seen. Or that I would finally end the scourge of LeChuck, burying him beneath a mountain of ice. Not me, that's for sure. Back then, the only thing duller than my sword was my wit. Now look at me. I'm married to the most beautiful governmental official in the Caribbean. The entire Tri-Island area shudders at the sound of my name. And now my Plunder Bunny and I are returning to Melee Island after the most incredible honeymoon in the history of-
Guybrush!
Yes, dear?
Dreaming and make yourself useful!
It's the grated door to the ship's cargo hold.
Snaggle cakes.
Elaine, could you untie me? The way I pushed that smelly pirate right over the rail. Now that's the stuff of pirates.
I hope the loyal citizens of Melee don't hurt themselves. I mean, you know, all the pushing and shoving on the dock to see my, our return. It'd be dangerous. Make sure this one stays on top.
Then there was the swab who came at me with a rusty fid. I sure taught him a thing or two about the proper use of deck chairs. Whoa. Got it.
The burden of being the governor of such an adoring yet unsophisticated public can be so draining. I'll be lucky if I can get a second to myself for months.
You know, we make a great team. The way we communicate, the way we work together, and the way we anticipate each other's every move. There's nothing we can't accomplish.
Oh well, here goes. Might as well get all the hullabaloo over with. What? Where is everyone?
Maybe everyone went to bed early?
Where's the welcoming committee? The banners? The crushing throng of well-wishers? Oh dear, do you know what this means?
We can spend another 3 months honeymooning.
No, you adorable numbskull. Something has gone horribly wrong while I've been away. Nothing else can explain.
What's that? Hey, it's Timmy the monkey. How are you, boy? Either the litter box is full or he's trying to tell us something. What is it, boy?
Timmy, is something wrong?
Free grog at the scum bar?
There's been an outbreak of scurvy?
You won 74 bucks playing bingo but lost it all playing banana futures.
There's trouble at the governor's mansion! Let's go!
Let's try 15, 4.2, well. Fire!
What do you think you're doing?
What does he look like I'm doing, fancy pants? I'm knocking down the governor's mansion.
You can't knock down the governor's mansion without approval from the governor.
Yeah. The governor's dead, man. Dead? What's the marriage that killed that, I say?
But I am the governor. Do I look dead to you?
No, ma'am.
Then cease and desist your boulder flinging immediately.
Yeah. Sorry, governor. I'm on the contract. I'm legally obligated to destroy your mansion with this here catapult.
Something's rotten on Melee Island.
I know. But the stench usually drifts away with high tide.
I've got a plan.
Although it sometimes lingers during an eclipse.
Guybrush!
Yes, dear?
I'm going down to City Hall to see about getting declared undead.
Won't that make you a flesh-eating zombie?
In the meantime, I need you to do two things for me.
More back rubs and foot massages?
Maybe later. First, I want you to put a stop to this insane boulder flinging.
Stop the insanity. Check.
Second, I want you to go to Lucre Island. Talk to my grandpa's lawyers. They might know how to help us fight City Hall.
Oh, but I hate talking to lawyers.
Not as much as they'll hate talking to you.
Okay.
Well, I've got a resurrection to perform. Be good, dear. And don't forget, stop the catapult, go to Lucre Island.
Sounds like the honeymoon's over.
She was a lot nicer before she died. That is one fat bird. Beady. strange mirror. What a strange mirror. It appears to be attached to the wall. Torturing complete strangers. Imprisoned company accepted, of course. Sold.
Ahoy there, fellow seafaring wastrels.
Gives!
Sorry about that.
you startled us.
Yeah, that's it. I startled.
You two look awfully familiar.
Oh, we have very common-looking faces. Isn't that right?
Oh, definitely. Can't swing a dead Chinook around here without hitting someone who looked like us.
Didn't we share a cruise to Monkey Island once?
I don't think so.
Carla, make the bad man stop! He's come to take us back to Monkey Island!
Carla?
Who?
You can't fool me. You're Carla, the Swordmaster of Melee Island. And you're Otis!
I don't know what you're talking about.
Let it go, Otis. The half-witch recognized us.
I knew you guys looked familiar. You were two-thirds of my original Monkey Island crew.
The crew you abandoned on Monkey Island, you mean?
Do you have any idea how difficult it is to escape from Monkey Island?
No. How difficult is it to?
Escape from Monkey Island.
Well... it's really difficult.
Yeah.
The whole experience was very traumatizing.
Scared us for life.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, well, sorry doesn't feed the narwhals, Buster.
Won't you join my crew? For old time's sake.
Guybrush, take a good look at Otis.
Monkeys! Monkeys is spreading up the monkeys!
That's what happened to him the last time we agreed to be part of your crew. Now, what in the name of Blackbeard's dandruff could possibly convince us to join you in another idiotic adventure?
Well, how about...
Then quit using your picking up Winch's voice. It's creepy.
Sorry. Well, how about...
a brand new car!
What?
Sorry, I kind of got caught up in the moment. Well, how about... cushy government jobs.
That sounds interesting.
Carla, what are you doing?
What kind of cushy government jobs are we talking about?
You know, the kind where you're paid 3 times the going private sector rate, no one checks your work, and it's impossible to be fired.
Don't listen to him, Carla. He just wants to take us back to Monkey Island.
We'd want contracts, of course.
I'll see what I can do. So, what have you rapscallions been up to?
Where to begin?
Whatever happened to Captain Smirk, the sword trainer?
He sold his house to a foreign investor.
But he didn't want to!
The investor challenged him to a round of insult gin rummy. And beat him.
Smith was so ashamed that he signed over the deed to his house on the spot and hopped the next ship out of Melee.
The same story's been repeated dozens of times all over Melee Island. This slimy investor strolls into a pirate's house or place of business, challenges him to a game of insult something or another, then humiliates them so badly that they have to cave into his hostile takeovers.
Haven't you noticed all the sword signs around here?
How about you, Otis? What have you been doing for the last few years?
Well, After I finally escaped it from Monkey Island, I made my way back to Melee Island, where I tried to resume my former profession.
Petty thievery?
I prefer to think of it as proactive redistribution of wealth. Unfortunately, the indignities I suffer on Monkey Island have left me so jittery that I cannot pick a lock or a pocket without making more noise than a flatulent hippo.
What vivid imagery. So how do you earn a living?
Begging mostly. You'd be amazed how many people will pay to hear the story of the innocent pirates who were betrayed by their idiot cat.
What have you been doing with yourself, Carla?
You mean after I finally managed to escape from Monkey Island?
You're never gonna forgive me for that, are you?
Not in this lifetime.
Anyhow, I've spent the last few years here on Melee Island re-establishing my Swordmaster credentials.
Well, that sounds productive.
Oh, it was, until that Australian showed up.
Australian?
Yeah. An Australian real estate developer. He challenged me to a round of insult sword fighting, badgered me into betting my house. It was over so quickly.
Gee.
Now I wandered the streets of Melee insult sword fighting for food.
How sad. I'm tired of rehashing the old days. Let's talk about the here and now.
If we must.
Be seeing ya.
Not if we see you first.
You know, I've never even been in there. I don't even think I'm registered to vote. Hey, mateys. Excuse me.
Buzz up, buzzard breath.
Yeah, can't you see we're busy here?
You're in a bar. You're playing darts. This is busy?
Listen, we're playing for the title of Grand Master Dart Champion of Melee Island.
Yeah, unless you're good enough to compete.
Which you are.
We'd advise that you take a long walk off a short pier.
There's so many holes in the wall around the dartboard.
Those are from other players.
Yeah, we never miss a shot.
Get out of here.
No, he. Pick a number. He hit it.
Hit a triple eight.
Oh, trying to be trickier.
I'm impressed. But you can't hit another one on the first shot.
Name it and I'll.
How about that post on the right side of the screen?
Oh, trying to be tricky, huh?
Nice shot. Well, I guess I'll be shoving off now.
Are you still here?
It says, happy birthday. Hi there, fellow swashbuckler. What's the word on the street?
Balzac!
How would you like to join my crew on a dangerous piratey mission? Let me get back to you on that. You look like a busy man. I'll let you get back to your self-destructive binge drinking. I guess he doesn't want anyone taking his birthday pretzels.
Hi there, scruffy-looking pirate person. I'm Guybrush Threepwood, mighty pirate. What's your name?
Cheese. Ignatius Cheese.
Wait a minute. Your name is I Cheese?
I
Cheese?
I.
What big arms you have, Mr. Cheese.
The better to insult, arm wrestle with, Mr. Threepwood.
Insult arm wrestling?
I. While you were away, the insult sword fighting paradigm became attached to a host of other pirate pastimes.
Paradigm?
Well, nowadays you can't throw a dart or play a game of checkers without being expected to toss in a withering bon mot.
I think I tossed a bon mot in a food fight once.
My particular speciality is insult arm wrestling, which I use to defend my bar from hostile takeovers.
Would you like to join my crew of mighty pirates, Mr. Cheese?
And what, pray tell, might I be finding myself doing if I joined this crew of mighty pirates?
You'd be traveling to Lucre Island with a crew of cretinous buccaneers to meet with my wife's lawyers.
Now that sounds like a worthy mission for a mighty pirate navigator like myself.
Really?
Aye. The seas around Lucre Island are very treacherous and can only be navigated by a skilled sailor. I'd love to face that challenge, but...
But what?
I can't.
Why not?
Because if I leave my bar for too long, it'll be stolen out from under me.
You're the owner of the scum bar?
Aye, the one and only.
What makes you think that the scum bar is going to be stolen?
Well, it's like this. I've been fighting off a hostile takeover bid from an Australian land developer.
Come again?
You heard me. A greedy Australian is making a grab for my bar.
With guns and swords and cannons?
Worse, with insults, jibes, and mockeries. It's taken all of my insult arm wrestling skill to keep him at bay.
Gosh, if it weren't for the whole wife being declared dead thing, I'd say that was the strangest thing I'd heard all week. Is there something I could do to convince you to navigate my ship to Lucre Island?
I'm open to persuasion. What do you have in mind?
If I beat you at insult arm wrestling, will you be my navigator?
That's an interesting proposition, Threepwood.
It is? I mean, of course it is.
How about this? If you beat me, I'll be your navigator.
Great.
But only if you teach me some new insults.
Agreed.
Well then, let's see what you've got.
Today, by myself, 12 people I've beaten.
Oh, how appropriate. You fight like a cow.
I've got muscles in places you've never even heard of.
Oh, it's too bad none of them are in your arms. You're the ugliest creature I've ever seen in my life.
I'm shocked that you've never gazed at your wife. My 98-year-old grandmother has bigger arms than you.
Yeah, but we both got better bladder control than you do. People consider my fists lethal weapons.
Could you repeat that?
People consider my fists lethal weapons.
Sadly, your breath should be equally reckoned. My stupefying strength will shatter your own into a million pieces.
Well, I'm surprised you could count that high. Give up now, or I'll crush you like a grape.
I would if it would stop your whining. I've out-wrestled octopi with these arms.
I'm shaking. I'm shaking.
Do I see quivers of agony dance on your lip?
It's laughter that's caused by your feathery grip. Only once have I met such a coward.
He must have taught you everything you know. My forearms have been mistaken for tree trunks.
I'm shaking. I'm shaking.
Your knuckles all grind into a splintery paste.
I am rubber. You are glue.
I won.
You did. Fair and square. Congratulations. You got yourself a navigator.
Even a life preserver will save what lies beyond that door. This fish has seen better days. The human body is a beautiful thing, most of the time. Hail and hello, oh master of all things groglike.
What can I do for you, Mr. Marley?
Threepwood.
Ah, right. Sorry about that, Mr. Threepwood.
Got any snacks?
I got some pretzels.
Well, that seems harmless enough.
Yep. The Scumbar's famous kudu jerky pretzels.
Ooh. Got anything else?
Not really.
No,
Okay, let's have some.
Sorry, can't give you any.
What? Why did you...
That drunk at the table over there? He has the last basket.
Can't you give them to me without a basket?
Sorry, it's scum bar policy.
Grog me, barkeep.
Why, I'd be glad to. After you show me some ID.
ID? I don't got to show you no stinking ID.
You do if you want any grog.
How'd you like to join a crew of courageous pirates on a dangerous quest?
Ooh, that sounds like fun.
Great.
But I should really check with my boss first. Hey, boss!
What?
Can I have a few days off to join Mr. Threepwood here on a swashbuckling adventure?
Are you out of your grog-addled mind?
No.
I've got troubles.
Like what?
The government is trying to blow up my house.
Well, that's a crying shame, Mr. Threepwood.
Yeah, if anyone's gonna blow up my house, it should be me. I need a ship to take me to Lucre Island.
You might want to try the Melee Island Municipal Shipyards.
And does Stan still work there?
Oh, no, no. The whole place is run by the Harbor Mistress these days.
Harbor Mistress?
Aye. She's very by the book. Although, she does have her tender side.
If her tender side is anything like the painting behind you, I don't want to see it. On second thought, I hate listening to myself whine.
You and me both, brother.
I've got to go.
Right, well, I'll do that.
Ahoy again, mateys! But you can't hit another one on the first shot.
Name it and I'll...
I bet you can't hit that balloon over there.
Ha! That's easy. Ah! Oops.
Wow, that's pretty good. Well, I guess I'll be shoving off now.
Are you still here?
He won't be needing these anymore. I wish I had some grog to wash that down with. Nothing happened. This table must have been a hand-me-down. Nothing happened. Nothing happened. Hey, look, a full moon. Anybody home?
No, go away.
But there's supposed to be a wax show today.
No, there isn't.
Yes, there is.
No, there isn't.
The sign out here says there is.
Yeah, that. Well, it's cancelled.
It's okay, it's me.
Me who?
Guybrush Threepwood, Mighty Pirate.
Nice try. Guybrush and Elaine are dead. I know why you're here, and you can't have it.
What are you talking about?
Stop pretending, you greedy old man. You think you can just buy up the whole island just because you can insult people? Well, think again. You can't take my house away from me if you can't get it. I knew I shouldn't have fixed that bridge.
Then who are you?
No one. There's no one here.
When do you expect someone to be home?
Later. Much later. Finish running your wife's errands first. There's nobody home. Now go away.
Okay. I'll come back later.
And just what do you want me to do about it?
Are you the harbor master?
No, I am the harbor mistress. My full title is Chief Assistant Shipyard Regulator, Harbor Operations, Malay Island, a division of Inter-Island Transportation Services.
Which means?
Which means I'm in charge of ship allocations on Malay Island.
Baby, you can be in charge of my ships any day of the week.
What? Are you trying to seduce a government employee?
No. So, you're in charge of the ships. Kinda snooty for a glorified barnacle watcher, aren't you?
You're just jealous of my cushy government job. It would be even better if I didn't have to put up with the likes of you.
I'm commandeering a vessel.
Not so fast, mister. No boat leaves this harbor without my permission, and I see no reason to give you permission to take one of my boats.
I'm married to the governor.
I heard she was dead.
Well, she does have her quiet moments, but she's alive and back on Melee and ready to govern.
Oh, so she's just been on vacation all this time, huh? That's nice. She won't be governor for long. I'm voting for Mr. Charles. He promised me a promotion.
Just give me a boat.
The rules prohibit the shipyard regulator, that would be me, from lending a boat to anyone who does not have proper authority. That would be you.
Isn't there some sort of loophole?
Nope. It's simple. Prove to me that you have the authority to requisition a ship, and I will follow procedure to supply one.
What would it take to get you to look the other way?
I really hope that you aren't trying to bribe an employee of the Malay Island government. Not that I care what happens to you, but I really don't want to fill out a paperwork.
Come on. Just this once? For me.
Not for you or anyone. Rules were meant to be followed. Just prove to me that you have the authority to requisition a ship, and I will follow procedure to supply one.
Never mind.
Now that I can do.
Hey, haven't I seen you somewhere before?
Sure, I don't know what you're talking about.
I know, at the scum bar. You're the naked girl in the painting.
I am not. Besides, I haven't taken my clothes off in years.
Who painted you?
He was an awful man. He was good, but he wouldn't take his claws off me. Strange, too. He had a bizarre fascination with rats.
You could lose your job if anyone found out that you posed for that picture.
How do you think I got my last promotion?
I'd rather not think about it.
What's your name?
Why?
I'd like to know the names of the people I've seen naked.
I wasn't naked. I was artistically posed.
You must be some kind of ship expert to land such an important and specialized job.
Nope. Don't know anything about them, and I can't stand sailing. I'm just paying my dues until I get a supervisor's job.
All this red tape is giving me a headache.
Don't say I didn't give you anything.
Let's try 47, 7.3, minus 14, fire!
Not a bad piece of modern art, if I do say so myself.
Hey, get away from there, before I pop you one in the head, capiche? Good. Now stay over there, pencil neck.
Excuse me.
What?
Please stop firing boulders at my house. It's very unnerving.
Sorry about that, kid, but I'm under contract.
What are those numbers you're muttering?
You know? I don't rightly know. They're supposed to be targeting numbers or something, but I'll be danged if I can figure them out. All I know is how to hit that cactus. Trying to extrapolate from there.
Could you show me how to hit the cactus?
Nah, I only do that when I think the catapult's out of alignment. I wouldn't want to waste one of these boulders. They're expensive.
What would it take to get you to stop flinging rocks at my house?
Permanently? Some kind of restraining order, I guess. You'd need some fancy lawyers for that.
Okay, how about temporarily?
Well, the union gives us liberal snack breaks during the day, but I don't have any snacks.
You seem like a busy man. I'll let you return to your evil deeds.
Thanks.
Right there.
Try.
Yeah. Just a sec.
47, 6.7, minus 14.
I brought you some kudu jerky pretzels.
Really?
Thanks. Really appreciate this.
You're welcome. You know, you could thank me by not chucking big old boulders at my house.
I could, but I won't. And leave me alone for a minute while I eat these.
Oh, I'm grateful.
No, I've heard it's bad to bother rabid animals while they're eating.
You're doing?
Nothing. I don't know what you're talking about.
You totally messed up my catapult. What you trying to do to me? You're killing me over here. Well, I guess I'm gonna have to start over at my calibration cactus over there. Get out of my way.
I hope this works.
There. It's recalibrated to the cactus. Let's try it. Fire! Do you have any idea what those things cost? They don't grow on trees, you know.
dead.
But don't worry. I'll love you even after rigor mortis sets in.
We've been gone so long, they didn't think I was coming back. So those numbskulls at City Hall declared me dead at sea.
What about me? Did they say anything about me?
No. Then they decided to sell all my belongings and destroy the mansion.
That's terrible. Did they sell any of my stuff?
And the worst part is, they've ordered a new election for the office of governor.
Maybe I should run.
So far, there's only one candidate. And, you know, the old slogan. If there's only one candidate, there's only one
choice.
Who are you?
The name, Mr. Threepwood, is Charles L. Charles. But you can call me the next governor of Melee Island.
You can't be the governor. I'm the governor. And it's a lifetime term.
Well, that's the rub, isn't it? You've been declared dead.
So I've heard. How did that happen?
Who can say? Perhaps if you'd spent a little more time governing and less time gallivanting all over the Tri-Island area with your pet monkey, the good citizens of Melee wouldn't have come to the mistaken conclusion that you were pushing up the petunias.
Wait a second. Was I the pet monkey in that last sentence?
Okay, we get it. You're running for governor. But why destroy my mansion?
Oh, that. When you died, the mansion became the property of the state. As a favor to me, the future governor of Melee Island, the town elders contracted a demolition firm.
That's me.
To destroy this outdated bourgeois symbol of the elitist piratocracy.
But why?
Because the days of pirate princesses ruling from secluded mansions are over, my friend.
They are?
Indeed they are, lad. If the Melee Island of tomorrow is to prosper, it must be governed by a man of the... A man unafraid to mingle with the common folk. A man who won't hide in a mansion guarded by vicious piranha poodles.
A man like you?
Precisely.
He makes a lot of sense, Elaine. I never did like those poodles.
Guybrush!
Well, I've got hands to kiss and babies to shake. Ta!
Really? That body smelled more like a rotting corpse.
I've got another plan.
But maybe a hint of oregano.
Guybrush!
Yes, dear?
I'm going back to City Hall to run against Charles.
Woohoo! How can I help?
Go to Lucre Island to talk to the family lawyers.
But why? I destroyed the catapult.
Yes, dearest, I know. But with that demolition order hanging over the mansion, another catapult could come at any moment. We need the kind of restraining order that only my family lawyers can provide.
But I want to come up with clever campaign slogans and do ops research.
Guybrush, love of my life, I'm a politician. Let me do what I do best. I'll let you do what you do best.
What's that?
Sailing around the Tri-Island area on seemingly pointless errands.
What?
Oh, I'm sorry. Did I say that out loud? What I meant to say was venturing into troubled waters on dangerous quests.
Well, okay then. That's more like it.
Okay. I'm off to start my campaign. Don't spend too much time on Lucre Island, dearest.
Got some heavy duty bagging to attend to.
I'd love to hear some more about the old Melee Island gang.
Like who?
Well, where's the third member of our old crew?
You mean Meat Hook?
That's a good question.
After we finally got off Monkey Island, Meat Hook renounced his piratey lifestyle and returned to his true passion.
Drinking?
Painting.
Painting? But the guy's got no hands.
That's what we say.
These stories are too depressing. Let's talk about something else.
If we must.
Be seeing ya.
Not if we see you first.